Well, I have a story for the next song. It's Sri Krishna Govinda, Hare Madame. And when I lived in the ashram, this was part of our morning chant. So every morning, we would kind of end our Sanskrit text chanting with this chant. And when I first moved into the ashram, I didn't leave the premises for a year. I was 20 years old, and so I didn't have a car, and I was very focused on the practices, and there was really nowhere to go. It was in upstate New York, kind of in the Catskill Mountains. And so I just, you know, was very focused on practices. And all of a sudden, it was a year later, it was Halloween, and we had some kids staying at the ashram. So a couple of friends asked me, do you want to go to the local store to get some candy for the kid? And I said yes, and then I thought, ooh, do I really want to leave this protective environment? Like, all of a sudden I got scared. Interesting, I really don't want to leave here. I, you know, I don't want to go out into the world. And they were going to go to this little store called James Way, which was kind of a Kmart type store. And I thought, okay, since I'm afraid, I have to do it. You know, you have to make yourself sometimes go through these. I mean, it was ridiculous. She's afraid to go into the world. And the whole teaching of this path is to see God in the world. So I wasn't doing a very good job of that. And I thought, okay, I'm going to go and I'm going to see God in James Way. And whoever, whatever strange people are there, I'm going to see God and whoever's there. And the whole drive, about a 50-minute drive, I was giving myself this whole pep talk. See God in James Way. I will see God in James Way. Power of thought. Okay, here's the secret in action. So we get to James Way, walk into the lobby area in the front, and there standing in front of me is Lord Krishna and his consort, Balaram. He was blue, wearing all the silks and the feathers. It was Lord Krishna standing in front of me. And they were selling cookies for the Hare Krishnas, which I guess was somewhere nearby. There was a Hare Krishna group. But can you imagine, after what I'd just been thinking, I walked in and there's Lord Krishna. And I had my red dot on. I would wear a red dot every day, and which signifies the devotion to the guru and to God. And I thought, well, I'm not taking it off just to go to James Way, you know. I don't care what people think about me. So Lord Krishna looks up as I walk in the door, and he says, look, Balaram, it's a devotee. And I swear, I felt like I was in front of Lord Krishna. And they gave me some, shall we give her some prasad? You know, so they gave me a cookie. And what would you say if you ran into Lord Krishna at James Way? So I said, well, you know, we chant Sri Krishna Govinda every morning. If I'd run into Shiva, I could have said, we chant the Shiva Mahimna every evening. So here's the chant. I'm going to use the tune, though, that Krishna Das usually uses. Number 3. Sri